it's very interesting that Hirco is coming to support the literary fest. Why would you have, you did highlight about it this morning, but why would a company involved in building cities be involved in literature?
Well, several reasons. Number one is we are doing a very major project in Chennai and we want to be local citizens.
Okay.
So to be that, we have to be part of life in Chennai.
Yeah.
I think the Literature Festival is a very big event in Chennai.
Yes.
And therefore, for us, it was important to be involved in it. But it is more than just a frivolous reason of being a local citizen.
Yeah.
It's also a strategic reason in the sense that we're not just building townships in terms of engineering inputs and steel at one point. Our philosophy is that we build life, create spaces and erect buildings, and it is in that order.
Mm-hmm.
And when we say we are creating life, then there is more to life than gardens and buildings and electricity and water treatment. Those are minimum hardware, but the software is the real life that is created in the town.
Right.
And therefore we want to be part of all aspects of life. We want to understand all aspects of life so that we can create that environment where a person has a fuller and more meaningful life.
Yeah. You know, even at the government level today, they're talking about PPP, public-private partnership. And even organizations that I'm involved in, like the Sangeet Natak Academy or Kalakshetra, many cultural bodies are now, you know, moving into that sphere. But with some circumspect, some suspicion as well. Because the profile of the two things are so different that it's almost, it can be a reason for something to fail for either. It's not just that, you know, you don't want a sportsman to be sporting a Marlboro cigarette, you also don't want an F1 player to be having a Coke because it sets huge trends among the children, but it's also about these very fragile things like art, like literature, like creative processes, like education, which are all very delicate and very, you know, they've been, they look healthy, but there's also very often a crying need for help, let's say in terms of education in India, where we want to look at the whole premise of what is good education. So how do these very contrary forces come together without bearing upon the other too harshly? Do you feel that there's a mismatch, or do you think it's...
Well, firstly, when you said PPP, my first reaction for me is, you know, you saw it as public-private partnership. It doesn't matter whether it's public or private, it's the partnership that's important.
That's right.
And whether it's public or private is a matter of ownership.
Right.
And that really shouldn't matter. Because if the goals are common,
absolutely,
then it doesn't matter whether it's a public company or a private company.
Yeah.
So long as both are efficient companies, so really in our view, you have the efficient sector and the inefficient sector, and they exist both private and public.
Right.
When we talk of PPP in our company, it's basically people, planet and profits.
Okay.
So we make sure that our people are looked after, planet is looked after. And there is profit at the end of the business, so you can do more because it's a means of creating wealth,
okay. More
wealth. So to give you a simple example, just now we are designing a school. And we agonized a lot about how the school is going to be designed in terms of its layout, seeing the type of education that is to be given. So we've had hours and hours of discussions with our architects in the US. We had hours and hours of discussion with educationists, not just about lighting and air circulation, but the type of environment that should be there in the school that is not memory-based, but creative-based, that allows each child to form his own thing.
Right.
So therefore, when I said that we want to be involved with the arts,
yeah,
and the same thing will be true when we start designing the hospital,
yeah,
that it's not just about having the best medical treatment or the best utilization of space, that's a very secondary thing. It's
right,
a means to an end, not the end in itself.
Right.
So that's where we see this congruence of various aspects of art, life in our business.
So because I think it's time that, you know, for a long time, organizations like CII, various other forward-thinking engineering groups have worried about this thing of the private sector owning, taking ownership for some of the things that they don't, they're not involved in, like the social sector, and like education, and like all the other health. But for us in the arts, it's really wonderful. It augurs very well for the future. If we can get over that terrible, you know, the big hump was finance. And in the arts in India, it's always supported. Even the sabhas are really supporting themselves in very meager amounts from banks and little donations and, you know, NRIs who put a certain amount down for. But the artist is still paid rather poorly, if I may say so. And yet, in terms of their expertise, they're on par with anybody, the best company or the best artist anywhere in the world, like our writers are actually. So it really augurs very well for the future if we can come together, but without, you know, with that same sense of social responsibility. But if you look at advertising,
but I'll just interrupt you. You know, our association here is a little more than
finance
or social responsibility. There is an inherent strategic interest. You know, there are three phases in a life of a human being or an organization. One of dependence when you're young, and then when you're a teenager, you want to be independent. And then as you get older, you become interdependent.
Yeah.
Some companies like us have understood the nature of the independence, interdependence between creating townships and art.
Right.
And therefore, our association with art is beyond just corporate social responsibility. We understand the invisible interdependence that is there in creating life,
right,
in getting a better quality of life. So, to be honest, it's not just a nice thing we are doing, it's also a little bit
of
self-interest. Of
course, and that is
That's when it becomes sustainable.
Right.
Because if it's just a one-way street, then someday the tap will go off.
Right.
So it's got to be that it's a mutual benefit, there's an interdependence.
Absolutely.
And
absolutely,
it then becomes sustainable.
That's wonderful. We are just trying.
And I'm lucky because I've had my grounding for over 33 years with Tata's. So that is now part of the DNA.
Yeah.
And that's what we built into the company. That it's not something you have to do. It's not something, it is a matter of habit.
Yeah.
It's not an act of consciousness.
Yeah.
It's just something that happens naturally. It is who I am or who we are as a company.
Absolutely.
And the type of people we employ, we make sure that they share the same values, that they have the same DNA that we want to build.
Right. Yeah, I think it's not just about you know, the money factor, but also just in India, my impression when I took over Kalakshetra, for instance, was that nobody dialogues, no institution dialogues with another institution also. It was sort of very isolated islands of great thought and great work, and, so that even two artists would not dialogue, or between a painter and a dancer there was no dialogue, between a dancer and a theatre person. And of course, between all those artists and the film artists, there was great suspicion, just because they're bigger and they have a wider reach. So we all had a very healthy disrespect for anybody in the film world, until I became CBF's chairman, where I realized that,
yeah,
you know,
like in industry,
these two industries must be brought together.
Yeah, we talk of cooperative competition.
Yes. No, competition is wonderful, but to look down or up at the two different genres of an art form, like films and theatre, or theatre and dance, these had become very strongly divided sectors. And I'm personally delighted that, you know, at last there is a dialogue between a top musician of the time, like Bombay Jayashree, and myself, so that we create something that is outside our own realms of experience. And there's wonderful dialogue between filmmakers and us now. I think that's also something that India has to get to do, is just partnering each other and holding hands and working together towards a better future.
Yeah.
Really.
we know what we don't know, so we are willing to learn from the arts.
Wonderful.
As engineers, we know that part of our business well. But about life, we realize we have to depend on art and literature to get us a better appreciation of life. So
I'm sure every writer here is delighted that, you know, Chennai at last, a literary festival opens up here. With every other kind of festival, but a literary festival. So.
We are delighted and thank God and thank Hindu for the opportunity.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you very much.
Thank you.